Hello everybody, this is Yogesh Singh from IC Bangalore. So this video is going to be about the community post problem solution I have been providing on this channel. So if you are preparing for GATE and if you have not tried those problems yet, then you should go and try those, because those are the good quality problem and such type of problem only come in GATE. Okay, so every day I'll be providing problems there and next day I'll be providing their solution. Okay, so let us start with the solution of the problem I have already provided there. So this is the community tab there, and we will start with this problem. This problem is from a signal and system. Okay, so what question says is which of the following is time invariant system. Okay, so to check whether the system is time variant or time invariant, from the relations between input and output we are given. So you do not go you do not have to go with the long method. Okay, so I have already told you with the shortcut you should go, and the shortcut is that if you get input and output relation like this, like if the output equals to some function of time into input, okay, if this relation is given, or if you get output equals to some function of time plus minus xt, okay, or if you get there is a basic function inside x, okay, there is input x and inside x there is a basic function. Okay, basic function can be time reversal or time scaling or any other basic function. Then if any of these three things is there, then you can conclude that the system is a time variant. Okay, now with this, let us move with the options we have for this question. So the first option we have is yn equals to n into xn, where n is the discrete time. Now first question, the first option matching with this first condition, okay, that is some function of time, that is n into multiplied with the input, right? So this is going to be time variant. Similarly, d option is also time variant, because cos 2 pi naught into n is from basic for some function of time, right? And this is multiplied with the input, right? So it's going to be a time variant. Now second, again some basic function is there inside the x, that is a time reversal, so it's also going to be a time variant. So the next, the b option we are left with, that is a time invariant. Okay, so for this we have to find out which is time invariant system. Okay, so b option will be correct with this. Okay, so let's move to the next question. So next question we have from digital electronics. Okay, so the question we are given is x is a function of four variable pqrs, so we are given like this. Y is also function of four variable pqrs, so we are given, and we are asked which is the correct relationship between x and y. Okay, so to solve this, let us find out what y min terms, what are the min terms y is having. Okay, so this is pq r bar s bar. Okay, so this is going to be 1 1, and this is going to be 0 0. P bar, Q bar, R bar, S bar, so all are going to be 0, 0. Similarly, P, Q bar, so it is 1, this is 0, this is R bar 0, and S bar is also 0. So what are the min terms we are getting from Y is? Min terms is 1100, it means that 12, and 0, 0, it is 0, and then it is going to be 8. So 3 min terms we got from Y, that is 12, 0, and 8. Now let's find out the min terms from R, this X, okay? So it's going to be R plus P bar Q, and it is R bar S. Okay, so P, Q and S is not there, so we will assume them don't care. Okay, so P, Q, R is there, it means 1, S is not there, don't care. P is there, 0, because bar is there, and then Q is there, it is going to be 1. R and S not there, then we will take them, don't care. Similarly here, P, Q we do not have, then don't care, don't care. R bar S, 0, 1. Okay, now let us see, 3 don't care we have, and we will have 8 possibility from this. Okay, so possibility are 0 0 0 and 0 0 1 and 0 1 0 and 0 1 1 and 0, okay, 0 1 1, after 0 1 1 we will have 1 0 0, that is 4. Okay, and 1, okay, yeah, 0 1 1, and then we are going to have 1 0 0 and 1 0 1 and 1 1 0 and then 1 1 1. Yes, and 1 is always there, so 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. Okay, so let us write down for P bar Q. So we have 2 don't care, then 4 possibility we will have is 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. Okay, and 0 1 is always there, so 0 1 0 1 0 1 and 0 1. Okay, and then for R bar S, 2 don't care, again 4 possibility, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 and 0 1 always there, 0 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, now let's find out the min terms. So 0 0 1 0 we have is 2, and this is 3, this is 1 1 0, this is 6, 01117. 1010, it is 10, and it is 11, it is going to be 14, and it is 15. Okay, now from P bar Q, what are the midterms we have? 0100, it's a 4, and it is 5, and 6, and 7. From here, we have midterm 1, this is midterm 5, and this is 9, and this is going to be 13. Yeah, so our total midterm from X, what we have got is, it is 2, this is 3, then 5, okay, and yeah, 4 is also there, so 4, then 5, then 6, 7, then 9, this is 7, 9, after 9, 10, then 11, and after 11 we have is 13, this is 13, 13, and then 14 and 15, okay, so how many midterms we have is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 midterms. Okay, this is in terms of midterms, and if you want to write a max term, so what we will get is the remaining midterms. So remaining midterms we have is 0 and 8 and 12. Okay, now if you see y is midterms 1208 and x is max term 0812, so x is going to be a complement of y. So relation with x of y we will have is x equals to y bar. So the correct option with this we will have is this b. This is a b, not a. Okay, now let us move to the next question. Again, the question we have is from signal and system, and the question is on identifying whether the system is time variant and linear. Okay, now time variant system, we know how to identify with the shortcut, and for linear also we have shortcut. That first condition is this: if no nonlinear operator on xt, okay, no nonlinear operator, there should not be any nonlinear operator on input. Okay, this is the first condition. And the second condition is, if you put xt equals to 0, then your output should also be 0. Okay, if these two conditions are satisfied, then you can conclude system is linear. Okay, now let us check relationship. What we are given is yt equals to t into xt. Okay, now let us check for linear and nonlinear. Now is there any linear operator? Okay, what we are given is yt equals to t into xt. Now let us check on xt, is there any nonlinear operator? No, because power of xt is 1, so it's a linear, right? So first condition is satisfied. Now if you put xt equals to 0, if you put it 0, then output you will get is t into 0. It means that output is also going to be 0. So second condition is also satisfied. So this system, that is yt equals to t into xt, is going to be linear. Okay, now let's check for time variant and time invariant. Since we know some function of time is multiplied with input, right? So it's going to be a time variant. So this system is a time variant and linear. Okay, time variant and linear. Okay, so the correct option with this is A, linear and time variant. Let's move to next question. So okay, this question is from a communication system. So what we are given is the input to a 1-bit quantizer. Okay, so a number of bit we are given is 1-bit. So quantizer we have, let us say this is this, and input will be coming something, and output we are giving is we will be getting is a quantized value of input. Let us input is x. So based on this threshold we will be deciding. Okay, now what we are given, the input to 1-bit quantizer is a random variable x. So this is the input of this quantizer, and input we are given is a random variable x, whose PDF we are given is 2e to the power minus 2x for x greater than equals to 0, and it is 0 for x less than 0. Now if you draw this, what you will get is at x equals to 0, what you will be getting is 2 to the power e to the power 0 means 1, it means 2. So this is a decaying, this is exponentially decaying, right? So this is x, this is 0. So for x less than 0, you are getting 0, and for x greater than 0, you got this function, that is 2 e to the power minus 2x. Okay, now what you are asked is for output to be equal probability. Okay, we have 1-bit quantizer, and then in the quantizer, you know, a number of level is 2 to the power n, or it is less than equals to 2 to the power n. Okay, now l is going to be less than equals to 2 to the power n, n is 1 here, number of bit. Okay, so l is maximum 2. So maximum we'll have two level. Okay, two level we will have, and then what we are asked is for output to be equal probability, then the quantizer threshold. So what threshold we should choose so that we have two levels and both level has to be equal probability. Okay, now since we have two levels, okay, then equal probability means both level will be having a half probability, then only the sum of probability will be one, right? Because we have only two levels. Okay, now this region is also having probability half, and this region is also having probability half. So with this condition we are asked what should be the threshold lambda. Okay, now let us say a threshold is lambda, and what we are asked is probability should be half in this region half, and also in this region we have half. So a probability we are given, okay, that is half, and you know a PDF we are given, this is f x of x. So in this region we know the probability. Okay, so if we are given the PDF, and if we are given a region in which we are asked the probability, then what we do, we just, you know, find out the area in that region. Okay, or we just integrate the PDF in that region. Okay, so this is lambda, and this is going to be infinity. So from lambda to infinity we will be integrating this region. Okay, this region means we will be integrating the PDF in this region. So this what we are given is half. This is the probability and we are given it half. Okay, now we will solve this. So lambda to infinity, what we have PDF, that is 2e−2x. So 2e−2x dx equals to half. Okay, now from this if you solve, 2 will take out, and then integration of this we'll have is e−2x/-2. The limit we have is 0 to lambda, that is half. Okay, now 2 will get cancelled out, and the minus will take out. So it's going to be e−2λ − e₀. Okay, so it's going to be half. Okay, so this is 1, and then e₀ we are having 1. No, this is 0 to lambda, not 0 to lambda. Limit we have lambda to infinity. Okay, this is lambda, and then it is going to be infinity. So e₀ ∞ e₀ −∞ we have 0, and then e₀ λ will be e₀λ. Okay, actually it is −2λ because 2 is there, so it's going to be −2λ. So it is half, and then e₀ −2λ is half. From this e₀2λ we will have is 2. Okay, then lambda we will get is half and ln 2. So if you solve this, what you will get is it's going to be 0.346. okay, so this is the threshold. For that we will get a probability half in both the sides of this threshold. Okay, now let's move to the next question. So the question is from a signal and system. Fourier series coefficient for the complex Fourier series are given as C0 we are given, C1 we are given, and C of minus 1 we are given. Okay, so what C0 we have is 3j. This is a complex Fourier series coefficient, and in complex Fourier series how you write xt? Xt you write is a summation of n equals to minus infinity to infinity, and then xt e₀jn⍵0t. Okay, now if you put n equals to 0 here, then what you will get is C of 0. Okay, this is not xt, this is a Fourier series coefficient, that is cn. Okay, now let's write it, this is a cn. Now this is going to be xt equals to, if you take n equals to 0 if you put, then you will get only c0. Okay, so c0 plus summation n equals to minus infinity to infinity, and cn e₀j⍵0t, here we will not put n equals to 0 because for n equals to 0 we have already taken c0 out. Okay, now what we are given is c0 is 3j, this is imaginary, and c1 is 1 + 3j, and c of −1 is 1 − 3j. okay, so from this if you observe, you get c1 equals to c of −1 conjugate. Okay, now similarly for c2 also, c2 we are given −2 − 5j, and c of −2 is −2 + 5j, so it is also conjugate. Okay, so c of −2 conjugate. Now you know when xt having a Fourier series coefficient cn, then x conjugate t we have Fourier series coefficient of c of −n conjugate. Okay, when xt is equal to x conjugate t, it means that xt is real, right? Because even if you take its conjugate, still you are getting the same signal, it means real. So we are getting cn equals to −cn conjugate here. सी वन इक्वस टू माइनस सी वन कॉन्जुगेट एंड सी टू इक्वस टू माइनस सी टू कॉन्जुगेट. सो फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन कंक्लूड फॉर एन इक्वस टू फॉर एन नॉट इक्वस टू जीरो वी आर गेटिंग सी एन इक्वस टू सी ऑफ माइनस एन कॉन्जुगेट. ओके सो फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन कंक्लूड एक्स टी इज गोइंग टू बी एक्स कॉन्जुगेट टू एंड देन वी कैन कंक्लूड एक्स टी इज रियल. सो दिस पोर्सन वेन एन इज नॉट इक्वस टू जीरो वी आर गेटिंग रियल. बट दिस सी नॉट वट वी हैव सी नॉट वी हैव इज थ्री जे दैट इज imaginary. So this is real, this is imaginary. So overall xt what we will have is a complex. Okay, so the correct option we will have is c. Now let's move to the next question. Okay, so the next question is from EMT. Okay, yeah, next question is from EMT. The question is for dominant mode propagation in air filled circular waveguide. Okay, so the question is from circular waveguide and we are in the question the mention is a dominant mode. Okay, so in a circular waveguide we should know the dominant mode for TE11 we get dominant mode. Okay, the cutoff wavelength we are given, so lambda c how much we are given is 20 centimeter. Okay, then what we are asked, the required cross section area of the guide. Okay, now we know the cutoff frequency formula for this circular waveguide is c by 2a or vp, that is a phase velocity. If it is air filled then we are taking as a velocity of light. So c by 2a into x and p dash divided by this is going to be pi. Okay, now in the dominant mode in the TE11 n is 1 p is 1, so x dash 11 we should know this is 1.841. Okay, maybe in the question it can be given, but we should remember this. Okay, maybe this in the question it is not given, so we have to remember this. Okay, now we are given cutoff wavelength lambda c. Okay, and lambda c equals to c by fc. Okay, now from this c by fc, so lambda c if we find, then what we will get is c by fc is going to be 2a pi divided by x 11 dash. Okay, for cutoff for a dominant mode this is going to be x dash 11. Okay, now lambda c what we are given is 20 centimeter. Okay, this is going to be then 10, and then from here we will find out a what we will get is 10 into x 11 dash we have what, so 1.841, so 1.841, and then it's going to be pi. So from this we will get a is 18.415 pi, where a is the radius of the circular waveguide, which is a radius of circular waveguide. So a we got, and what we are asked is a cross section area of circular waveguide, it's going to be pi r square, right? So pi into r means radius, this is a if we take from here 18.41 divided by pi square. Okay, so from this you'll get 18.41 square and then divided by pi means 3.14. okay, so if we solve it you will get 107.8. okay, so the correct option we have is c. Now let's move to the next question. Yeah, question is again from EMT, and what we are asked is for TE30 mode in a rectangular waveguide, which of the following field component exists? Okay, now to solve this you should know the basic or the shortcut, because such type of question how we will solve is, if we are given TE it means that transverse electric, it means that electric field is in the transverse of direction of the propagation of wave. Okay, so electric field is in the transverse it is perpendicular to the direction of propagation, then in the propagation of direction what we will have is HZ then. Okay, let us say a wave is traveling in z direction, then hz what we will have is h naught cos, the magnitude will be cos m pi by a into x into sin m pi by b into y. Okay, this is hz, and ez is going to be zero because it is in transverse. Okay, now we have to find we have to comment on ex, ey and hx and hy, which component will be existing. Okay, so from this we can say hz will exist. Yeah, this is for sure, hz will be existing. Now we have to comment on these four. Okay, now from this the shortcut is ex, if you have to write now the electric field, if you write then you have to there is x, if there is x then you have to go to the x component, if it is y then you have to go with the y component. Okay, this is not sine, this is going to be cos only in case of h, So this is going to be cos m pi by b into y. Okay, so this is x here, then you have to go with x component. If in case of electric field it is y, then you have to go with y component. Then with this, what you will write, you will just copy paste it. So it is going to be cos m pi by b into y into remaining, you have to take sine, then sine n. Okay, this is m, this is going to be n. Yeah, this is then n. So cos n pi y, yeah, cos n pi y by b, and then sine m pi y a into x. Okay, similarly here, this is in electric field, the x component you have to find, then you have to go with the cos component. Okay, so this is going to be cos, you will be copying pasting this cos term, cos m pi y a into x. Okay, and then for the second one you have to take sine. So sine, this is going to be what, n pi y b into y. Okay, and another thing you should know, that ex is going to be equals to ey, and hx is going to be ey. Ex is going to be equals to hy, and hx is going to equals to ey. So this much you will get from this, if you know this trick, right? So from this, what we are given, m equals to 3 in the question, and n equals to 0. If you put n equals to 0, then this is going to be 0. So ex will not exist. So ex will not exist. If you put again n equals to 0 in this, n equals to 0, and then m is there, so this will exist. It means ey will exist. Okay, when ex is not existing, then hy will also not exist, right? So ex and hy will not exist, because ex equals to hy, and when ey is existing, then hx will exist, right? So what are existing? Ey, hx, and hz. Okay, and ez, ex and hy are 0. So existing component are hz, ey, and hx. Okay, so hz, ey, and hx. So C option will be correct. So yeah, we are done, and this is the question we posted today. We will see its solution tomorrow. So let's end it.